So it's December already, and it's that time of year when you might be thinking about getting gifts for your loved ones or your favorite colorists or editors. And I think I've found the perfect gift for DaVinci Resolve users. It's the Elgato Stream Deck. This is a fantastic little device that I've been playing with for a couple of months now. So in this episode, I'm gonna show you how I use it. I'm gonna show you how to configure it, and I'm gonna show you other uses for it as well. It's not just for DaVinci Resolve. I'm using it for all sorts of stuff. I've got Spotify on there, Premiere, I've got websites, I've got all sorts of stuff just to make my everyday things much quicker with just a single hit of a button. So let's go and take a look. So what is the Elgato Stream Deck? It's basically a small box that's your USB connected device with a series of buttons on it. And you can basically program those buttons to do whatever you want. You don't need to be a programmer to operate it. I'm certainly not a programmer. I'm gonna show you how I work with it. But it basically comes in four different configurations. There is a 6-button device. There is 2 15-button devices. One of them has a customizable front. And there is a 32-button version, which is the one that I'm using here. So this has traditionally been used by gamers. So when they're doing their live streams, they can just literally press a button and it will change a camera angle, or it will give a shout out or something like that. But over time, I've seen a lot more DaVinci Resolve users using it. And that is because it is so flexible. You can literally program this to be any shortcut that you've got in DaVinci Resolve, and you've got it at a press of a button. So even though I'm working on the advanced control surface, the advanced panel, I'm still finding this really useful. So let's have a look at how it works. So to access the configuration, you need to go up to here, this little icon here, Configure Stream Deck, and it opens up. And this is now an emulation of what I'm looking at on my actual unit. So obviously these are nice little LCD displays, but it looks exactly the same as this. So what we've got here is my default profile. This is the profile that will load when I first launch my computer. So instantly on my front page, I've got access to Resolve here, obviously, Premiere, Photoshop. I've got access to my email, and I'll take you through this in a little while. First, I want to show you how we actually configure this ourselves. So I'm going to make a brand new profile. And by making profiles, it allows us to do a single button action and move through different parts of the software. So for example, when I launch DaVinci Resolve, it automatically triggers a new profile, which is my DaVinci Resolve profile. So I'll show you that in a moment. But first of all, let's have a look at what happens. You've got this welcome button. If you press that, it's going to take you straight to the Elgato website. So we can get rid of that for a start. Down on the right-hand side, we've got all the sort of function keys. So these are doing the programming for us, if you like. I'm not a programmer. I'm going to show you how simple it is to do. So at the top here, we've got OBS Studio. This is dedicated to working with OBS, which is what I use for my live streams. But down here where we've got Stream Deck, this is what we're interested in. Okay, so these functions down here and these here are our basic functions for getting the Stream Deck to do something. So the easiest one probably is this one called Open. If you just literally drag and drop that on, you can then choose the app that you want it to open. So let's just choose it, go to our applications, and just choose whatever you want. I don't know, it might be VLC player, for example. I want to launch my Omniscopes. So let's just press that in there. And that button now will launch Omniscope. It's as simple as that. That's programmed. That's done. It's as simple as that. Other simple ones is here we've got website, for example. So you can just drag and drop and type in a URL for your favorite websites. So I've got one that connects straight to Radio 6 Music, which is what I listen to generally when I'm color grading. This text one here is really straightforward as well. What it does is every time you press it, it literally types text. So I've got one button here that does my email signature. So literally if I'm logging into something, I can just press that button, it types out my full email address. I've got one that's a signature that I use on emails. So again, you just literally add the text. And every time I press that button, it's gonna write Stream Deck for Christmas. So it's really that simple. If you want more than 32 buttons, or let's say for example you've bought the 15 button version and you want more than 15 buttons, what you can do is create a folder. Okay, and this will allow you to go to the next tier down. The other way of looking at it is building profiles. Okay, so I was mentioning that when I press DaVinci Resolve button, it launches a new profile, which is all my DaVinci Resolve settings. Now it starts to get to the next level when you start doing multi-actions. So I've got my multi-action, if I just drag and drop that on, the first action would be to open, and that would be linked to DaVinci Resolve. And my second action would be to switch profile, and I change it to be the DaVinci Resolve profile. And you can assign multi-actions to be many different things. So it might be a six-step function that it needs to do. And I could put the DaVinci Resolve icon on here. In fact, let me show you how to do that. If I click on here, if you press this button here, you can say set from file, so you can create your own icons. You can say create new icon, which takes you into this icon builder, which I'm not a huge fan of, to be honest, but it does work. Or you can open the Streamdeck icon library, and in here, there's a load of pre-made icons. Now, you can actually install extra packs. So I've installed the DaVinci Resolve pack, I've also installed the Premiere pack, and they're just down here. So they give you a load of, these are absolutely free, icons that relate to DaVinci Resolve. So there is the actual DaVinci Resolve logo, and you can now see that that's been assigned. Now, if you want to install new packs, you need to click on here. And you go to icons, and down here you'll see lots of different programs have made their own icons that you can literally install. So you just press install. So if you want Illustrator, for example, you just press install. And that is now installed in the icons. The other thing you can do is look at these plugins. So there are various plugins that you can get. So for example, I've got this analog clock, which I've installed, which I'll show you in a moment. But you can go down here and there's loads of different things. In fact, you've even got here, there, lighting. So if I install this, you can actually control your, if you've got the Philips Hue lights, you can actually control them from your Stream Deck. You see that's now installed itself at the bottom. So I can switch my Philips lights on and off. I can change the color of them. We can change the brightness of them. And that's done. All I need to do now is link that to the Philips Hue system itself. And we're controlling all that off our Stream Deck. So it's fantastic. So now you've got the idea of how easy it is to actually program this thing. I'm going to show you what I've done so far. So let's have a look at my default profile. So across the top here, I've got all my OBS buttons. Now, if you ever see me do a YouTube live, you'll know that I mess it up quite a bit because I normally get confused with my keyboard shortcuts. This is helping me alleviate that problem because these buttons here are talking directly to OBS. All these buttons have come from the presets up here from OBS Studio. Okay, so my source here is these. So each of these is a source, and I literally have changed it to be wherever I need it to be. So these are all for my live streaming. This one launches OBS itself. I will be doing a new live soon, so this is probably a good opportunity to subscribe and hit the notification bell, then you'll know when that is. This one here opens my Spotify, Premiere, Photoshop. This is my email, BBC Six Music, and this is my DaVinci Resolve one. So let me just show you what the other ones are, and then I can show you Resolve specifically. There's my little analog clock, which I love having down there. This one here is switch profile, so I can literally cycle through all my different profiles really easily. This is when I'm on Zoom, so I can mute my camera, just literally pressing a button on here. And this starts my stream, and this mutes my microphone. So these are all things that I use a lot. These ones are to do with my YouTube channel, so this one takes me directly to my comments. As you know, I still do answer all the comments where possible. I've even got a little button to get me there super quick, so I can answer all your comments. So these are the things I'm using all the time, but the main thing I'm using this for is when I'm working with DaVinci Resolve. So let's have a look at this icon here. If I click on this one, okay, you can see that it's a multi-action and there are two actions. All right, let's click on that. The first action is to open DaVinci Resolve, and the second action is to switch the profile. So let's have a look, let's actually do it and see what happens. Now obviously DaVinci Resolve is already open in the background, but I'm gonna press the switch anyway. So what's happened now is I've switched to the DaVinci Resolve profile, and I'm going to show you what that looks like in my configurator. And basically I've got always down the bottom here, I've got switch profile and main page. So I can always go back to that front page. But up here, I've now got the media page, cut page, edit page, fusion, color, fairlight, and deliver page. All right, so just by pressing any one of these takes me to that section. So if I'm in the color page at the moment, if I want to go to the edit page, I literally just press the edit button. Okay, and what that does is loads up my editing profile. All right, so I've now got the edit page profile. So my profile so far, I've not completely configured this at all yet. You can buy preset configurations, by the way, as well. There are companies out there doing DaVinci Resolve packs where it's fully featured and loaded. But I'm gonna add a new one for you now and show you exactly how easy it is to do that. So this is my edit page profile. So when I press the edit button, it goes to my edit page profile. And you can see I've got insert, overwrite, all that sort of stuff. So down here, I've got markers. I'm gonna go to add the blade tool. That is basically a hotkey. Okay, hotkey is like a shortcut. So all I have to do here is assign the DaVinci Resolve keyboard shortcut for blade, which is Command B, and that is now assigned. Now that icon doesn't look great. It's not very easy for me to see what that is. So let's change the icon as we did before. I'm going to open the Stream Deck icon library. I'm going to see if there's anything suitable. And in the DaVinci Resolve icon pack, which is free as part of Elgato, I'm going to take this razor blade icon here. So let's just double click that, close it down, and that is a far more suitable icon. Now, if you want to assign your own things and there isn't a keyboard shortcut for it in Resolve, all you need to do is go to your keyboard customization and look for a key that's not taken. So to do that, if you want to press, say, let's say, for example, Control Shift, you can start pressing buttons and seeing if anything's assigned. So Control Shift G is not assigned to anything. Okay, Control Shift S isn't. So Shift S is audio scrubbing. Okay, so you can easily see what's assigned and what's not. And then all you've got to do is add your own keyboard shortcut to that and then assign that as your hotkey. So let me show you an example of that. Let's go back to our Stream Deck. And what I'm going to do now is go to the color page. So if I click on this button here, it takes me to the color page. So let's just click on here. I'm going to click color. That's changed my profile to be the color page profile, which looks like this. Okay, and now you can see what buttons I'm using on my Stream Deck, even though I've got the advanced panel. So the main thing I've got going on here is, or the most obvious thing I've got going on here, is these printer light buttons. So the printer lights refer to what's going on down here. Okay, so it's these red, green, and blue here in the offset. And I use this a lot. This is one of my first primary parts of my grading. And now, whichever one of these I press is a quarter point change in printer light. So if I want to bring red up slightly by one quarter point, if I just press that once, that moves it up a quarter point. I want to move blue down, so it moves it down one quarter point. And let's add a bit of yellow. So there we go. So that's made it really easy for me to do that. Now, I can also do that on the advanced panel, but it's actually much clearer for me to see what's going on the Stream Deck than it is on the panel itself. So some functionality is better on the Stream Deck. If you haven't got an advanced panel and you're working with one of the other panels, this becomes even more valuable because things like here, you can see, let me just bring up the interface again. I've added these memories. So I've got four memories on here. You could have 32 memories on it or 16 memories on here. I've just put those in to show you what I think would be a good idea to do if you had the mini or the micro panel. Obviously on the advanced panel, it's really easy for me to do that. So that's kind of excessive buttons. However, what I have done is add down here my playheads. So I've got A, B, C, and D. Now I've got playheads on the advanced panel, but annoyingly now, since the version 17 button change, I now have to do this. So to change my playhead, so my playheads are down here, okay? I have to shift down, press playhead, and then select the playhead, which is actually a three button press. So on my Stream Deck, I can do that with one button. Just press A on here, and that's updated. Go to D, and that is a one button press. So it's much, much easier for me to do that on the Stream Deck than it is on the advanced panel itself. And I just want to show you how easy it is to make your own icons. So I'm going to open the software. And for my playheads, let's go to my color page profile. For these playheads, I wanted these actual icons from the interface. They didn't really have them in the pack looking any good. So all you got to do is go down here. Here's my actual playheads. And all I did was separate them out a little bit. And let's take A, and I just press Command-Shift-4 on my Mac keyboard, and I literally screen grabbed that. So what that does is screen grab just the portion that's highlighted. Okay, that gave me this little PNG file. Go to my software again, and I can literally take that icon there, and I'm going to replace it. So I'm going to say Set From File. And you go to my desktop, and it's the last screenshot that I just grabbed. I'm going to open that up, and there it is. So you can literally just screen grab. So I think it says somewhere you need it to be a certain pixel size and whatever. You don't. You just literally screen grab like that. I don't know how to do that in Windows, I'm afraid, but I'm sure someone can put that in the comment. The beauty of the Stream Deck is you can have multiple Stream Decks working together, so they actually work in harmony. So if you were thinking of gifting one to someone and they've already got a Stream Deck, they're still going to be really happy with it because you can just gang them together. And if you don't get one as a gift and you're expecting one, just go out and buy yourself one because it's a fantastic bit of kit. I've also put in my descriptions, they are affiliate links, so I might get a bit of a kickback, but it will be exactly the same price to you, and it links directly to where you can buy the Stream Decks from. So I've still got a lot of programming to do on this, but I think you get the general idea of how easy it is to use and how functional it is. I mean, it works with any program you can think of, well, to the best of my knowledge anyway. There are people writing some serious macros for this as well, so if you have a look on GitHub, for example, there are tons of stuff for Stream Deck on there. I know some of my friends in the industry have got some very deep knowledge on how these work and how their macros work, but I'm just a simple colorist. That is how I've configured mine so far. I absolutely love it. It sits beautifully next to my advanced panel here. It's just a real nice compliment to the suite. So I hope that's been helpful for you, and look after yourselves, and I'll see you in the next episode.